Peter Schickele. Peter Schickele is an American composer, musical educator, and parodist, best known for comedy albums featuring his music, but which he presents as being composed by the fictional P.D.Q. Bach. He also hosted a long-running weekly radio program called Schickele Mix. From 1990 to 1993, Schickele's P.D.Q. Bach recordings earned him 4 consecutive wins for the Grammy Award for Best Comedy Album. Schickele was born in Ames, Iowa, to Alsatian immigrant parents. His father, René Schickele, son of the writer René Schickele, was an agricultural economist teaching at Iowa State University. In 1945, Schickele's father took a position at George Washington University in Washington, D.C., then, in 1946, became chairman of the Agricultural Sciences Department at North Dakota Agricultural College in Fargo, North Dakota. In Fargo, Schickele studied composition with Sigvald Thompson. He attended Fargo Central High School, graduating in 1952. He then attended Swarthmore College, graduating in 1957 with a degree in music. He was the first student at Swarthmore, and the only student in his class, with a music degree. He was a contemporary of Ted Nelson at Swarthmore, and he scored Nelson's experimental film, The Epiphany of Slocum Furlow. It was his first film score. He graduated from the Juilliard School with a master's degree in musical composition. Schickele wrote music for a number of folk musicians, most notably Joan Baez, for whom he also orchestrated and arranged 3 albums during the mid-1960s, Noel, Joan, and Schickele, an accomplished bassoonist, was also a member of the chamber rock trio The Open Window, which wrote and performed music for the 1969 revue O. Calcutta, and released 3 albums. The humorous aspect of Schickele's musical career came from his early interest in the music of Spike Jones, whose musical ensemble lampooned popular musician the 1940s and 1950s. While at Juilliard, Schickele teamed with conductor Jorge Mester to present a humorous concert, which became an annual event at the college. In 1965, Schickele moved the concept to the town hall and invited the public to attend. Vanguard Records released an album off that concert, and the character of P.D.Q. Bach was launched. By 1972, the concerts had become so popular that they were moved to Avery Fisher Hall at the Lincoln Center. Besides composing music under his own name, Schickele has developed an elaborate parodic persona built around his studies of the fictional youngest and the oddest of the 20-odd children of Johann Sebastian Bach, P.D.Q. Bach. Among the fictional composers' forgotten repertory supposedly uncovered by Schickele are such farcical works as The Abduction of Figaro, Canine Cantata, Vacatarf, Good King Kong Looked Out, The Trite Quintet, O Little Town of Hackensack, A Little Nightmare Music, The Cantata Iphigenia in Brooklyn, The Concerto for Horn and Hardart, The Art of the Ground Round, Blauis Grass, and perhaps best known of all, the dramatic oratorio, Oedipus Rex, featuring the OK Corral. Though P.D.Q. Bach is ostensibly a Baroque composer, Schickele extends his repertoire to parody much more modern works such as Einstein on the Fritz, a parody of his Juilliard classmate Philip Glass. His fictitious home establishment, where he reports having tenure as very full professor Peter Schickele of musicology and musical pathology, is the University of Southern North Dakota at Hoople, which is described as a little-known institution which does not normally welcome out-of-state visitors. To illustrate the work of his uncovered composer, Schickele invented a range of rather unusual instruments. The most complicated of these is the hardart, a variety of tone-generating devices mounted on the frame of an automat, a coin-operated food dispenser. The modified automat is used in the concerto for horn and hardart, a play on the name of proprietors Horn and Hardart, who pioneered the North American use of the automat in their restaurants. Schickele also invented the dill piccolo for playing sour notes, the left-handed sewer flute, the trombone, the lasso d'amore, the double reed slide music stand, which he described as having a range of major third and even less expressiveness, the tuba mirum, a flexible tube filled with wine, and the pastaphone, an uncooked tube of manicotti pasta played as a horn. Further invented instruments of his include the pump flute and the proctophone. The uberklavier or super piano, with a 15-octave keyboard ranging from sounds which only dogs can hear down to sounds which only whales can make, was invented in 1797 by Clark Kant, a Munich piano maker who demonstrated the instrument for P.D.Q. A sample of a piece written for the uberklavier, the Transcendental Etudes, appeared in P.D.Q.'s unauthorized autobiography, published in 1976. P.D.Q.'s Pervertimento for Bagpipes, Bicycle and balloons demonstrated the inherent musical qualities of everyday objects in ways not equally agreeable to all who listen to them. To some degree, Schickele's music as P.D.Q. Bach has overshadowed his work as a serious composer. During the 1970s and early 1980s, performances by Schickele of the music of P.D.Q. Bach often featured guest appearances by the Swarthmore College Choir, usually advertised as fresh from their recent tour of Swarthmore, Pennsylvania. Schickele performed two concerts to commemorate the 50th anniversary of his first concert at the Town Hall in New York on December 28 and 29, 2015. He has since reduced his concert appearances due to health issues, but continues to have live concert performances scheduled through 2018. Schickele has composed more than 100 original works for symphony orchestra, choral groups, chamber ensemble, voice, television, and an animated adaptation of Where the Wild Things Are. He made a brief foray into cinema with the Bruce Dern film Silent Running, for which he composed the musical score and co-wrote the original song Silent Running and Rejoice in the Sun with Diane Lampert. He has also written music for school bands, as well as a number of musicals, including O. Calcutta, and has organized numerous concert performances as both musical director and performer. Schickele was active on the international and North American concert circuit. Schickele's musical creations have won him multiple awards. His extensive body of work is marked by a distinctive style which integrates the European classical tradition with an unmistakable American idiom. Schickele has also created such not-quite-P.D.Q. Bach albums as Hornsmoke, Sneaky Pete and the Wolf, and The Emperor's New Clothes. Schickele's music is published by the Theodore Presser Company. As a musical educator, he also hosted the classical music educational radio program Schickele Mix, which aired on many public radio stations in the United States. The program began in 1992, lack of funding ended the production of new programs by 1999, and rebroadcasts of the existing programs finally ceased in June 2007. Only 119 of the 169 programs were in the rebroadcast rotation, because earlier shows contained American Public Radio production IDs rather than ones crediting Public Radio International. In March 2006, some of the other lost episodes were added back to the rotation, with one notable program remnant of the periodic table of musics, listing the names of musicians and composers as mythical element names in a format reminiscent of the periodic table. Schickele's two children, Matt and Carla, are both indie rock musicians. The two play together in the indie rock trio Beekeeper in the 1990s. Carla Schickele then joined the band Ida, has recorded solo music under the name K-Matt Schickele, and is part of the M. Shanghai String Band. She is also an orchestral music composer. Schickele's brother, David Schickele, was a film director and musician. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.